Oh, Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Pastor got me today. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I've been running for this long time ago. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is Lord.
Amen.
I have a prompting this morning.
Come on.
Talking to us.
Thank you.
On the topic that says fasting and the prayer structure. Praise the name of
God. Hallelujah.
Fasting and the Lord's prayer structure. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of God.
Hallelujah.
Many of you are set to hear from God.
Come on. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are set to hear from
Amen.
God.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
And the Lord will speak to you.
Amen.
The Lord will speak to you this way.
Amen.
He will speak to you.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, the Lord will speak to you.
The Lord will speak to you.
The Lord will speak to you.
Amen.
This morning, I want you to set yourself aside to hear from God. You will not hear from man this morning. You will hear from only God.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible to the book of Isaiah, chapter 40. Isaiah 40. We're going to start from verse 29. The Bible says, "He gave power to the faint and to them that have no, to them that have no might, he increased their strength." Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
"Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall." The Bible says, "But they that wait upon the Lord
come on.
Shall renew their strength."
Amen.
"They shall mount up with wings as eagles."
Amen.
"They shall run,
yes,
and not be weary."
Amen.
Father, in Jesus' name,
yes, Lord.
Father, we thank you for your word this morning.
Yes, Lord.
We pray, O Lord, that you come and have your lead. Teach us your word this morning.
Amen.
Let your word that will be coming from the throne of grace today, let it heal.
Amen.
Let it deliver.
Amen.
Let it bless.
Amen.
Let it move us forward.
Amen.
Lord, speak to us this
morning.
Speak to us this morning.
Amen.
Speak to us this morning.
Amen.
Let the opening of my lips be filled with your power.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
Open our eyes of understanding.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, let us be the doer and the hearer of your word.
Amen.
Not the hearer alone, but the doer of your word.
Amen.
Lord, help us this morning. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says, "He gave power to the faint."
Come on.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This morning I'll be talking to us on the topic fasting and prayer structure.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, God has a standard.
God has a standard.
And he has a structure.
Oh, come on now. Come
God on. Has a standard.
God has a standard.
And he has a structure.
And he has a structure.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, "They that wait upon the Lord, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall run and not be weary." Until you wait upon the Lord, your strength cannot be renewed. Praise the name of the Lord.
Come on,
if
amen.
You don't wait upon
come
the Lord,
on,
it's going to be harder than a rock. The Bible says, "By strength shall no man prevail." Put it together. By strength shall no man prevail. It is only to them that wait. It is those that wait upon the Lord. Tell your neighbor, wait upon the Lord.
Wait upon the Lord.
In anything you are doing, wait upon the Lord. The Bible says, "Those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength." Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, fasting is a spiritual mandate. Amen.
Amen.
Is it God's mandate for us? The Bible says, "Men ought to pray and not to faint."
Come on, yes.
Pray Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you obey God, you will fulfill His promise.
Amen.
If you don't obey God, you cannot fulfill His promise. Amen.
Amen.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt act diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God.
Amen.
Everybody say diligence.
Diligence.
And it shall come to pass.
Yes.
If only you hearken, if you don't hearken, it will not happen. It will only happen if you obey. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to do one illustration this morning. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 23, as he said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days
of my life.
Amen.
Surely goodness and mercy can only follow you if you abide. If you seek it first, the kingdom. Surely goodness and mercy can only follow you if you wait upon the Lord. Many of us, we display our strength, and all is all equal zero. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That was his by strength shall no man prevail.
Yes, sir.
Your strength is amounted to zero. So fasting is a spiritual mandate.
Amen.
Amen. So please, let's all obey. Let's get into it. Is it time of blessing? Is it time to move forward? Is it time of our goodness? Is it time of our advancement? Is it time to seek the face of God?
Come on, is it time to fast? Yes, sir.
Is it time to pray?
Amen.
Everyone say pray.
Pray.
Everyone say fast.
Fast.
Is it time to pray, to fast and pray? Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to go through my notes real quick and let me get some.
Thank you.
Fasting details to us and as we move forward. Amen.
Amen.
So fasting is transferring from natural to supernatural. Amen. So when you fast, your spiritual antenna gets sharper than before.
Come on.
Now, I notice, so personally, when I fast and pray, God reveals some dangerous things that are on my way to me, so that I'll be able to know how to take care of it.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? And the place of fasting is a place of the secret place of God. This is a place at which God will call you to check you, to put you together. Is a secret place. They that wait upon the Lord. The place of prayer fasting is a secret place. It's a place at which riches, knowledge, understanding is. You can't finish two bowl of rice and think it's going to manifest. You're going to get distracted. Fasting brings you to be focused.
Come on. Yes,
position you to the next blessing of
come
the Lord.
On. Yes, sir.
Fasting will make you focus and see those are, you know, where God wants you to hit and what direction God wants you to go.
Yeah.
The Bible says in the book of Psalm 23, again, it said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life, and I will dwell as I dwell in the house of the Lord. If you don't dwell, the place of prayer fasting is the place of house of the Lord.
Come on.
Yeah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please, let's take it serious.
Thank you, Lord.
Tell everyone, you have your work to do.
You have your work to do.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I hope I'll be able to get to my note this morning. Hallelujah. So if you allow natural body to rule you, you can't walk in supernatural. A place of fasting is a place of supernatural. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to be going through this morning some requirements of fasting. Everybody say requirement of fasting.
Requirements of fasting.
God has instruction. Amen.
Amen.
Fasting is not just missing a meal.
Mm.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Fasting is not a diet.
Come on.
Praise the name of God.
Hallelujah.
Woo!
Fasting replacing the reading of the word of God and prayer for your meal, for your meal time. What I'm trying to say is that the time you used to start preparing your food, your breakfast, your lunch and your dinner, you replace it to pray and to study the word of God. So on that note, you get more focus. Praise the name of the Lord. And prayer for Christian is a powerful Christian.
Amen.
If you are not prayerful, you cannot be powerful. The Bible says, the scripture, the last scripture, Brother Tunji said that he gave last two Sunday, God spoke to me on that scripture.
Amen.
Luke chapter 21, verse 15, if I'm not mistaken. He said, I will give you a mouth and wisdom in which your adversary will not be able to gainsay or resist. So if God give you a mouth and you don't use it in the place of prayer.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor,
use your mouth.
Use your mouth. So your mouth has been given to us as a deliverance.
Yes.
So if you are still under bondage, you are not in the right place. A mouth has been given unto you. Tell your neighbor, you are responsible. Tell your neighbor again, you are responsible. For I will give you a mouth and wisdom in which your adversary. The case is settled.
Come on. Amen.
The case is settled. Tell your neighbor, my case is settled.
My case is
because you have all the text. You have all the text to deliver.
Amen.
You have all the text to triumph.
Yes, sir.
You have all the text to prosper.
I receive it, Lord.
So I will give you thank a you. Mouth and wisdom. So you have the wisdom.
Amen.
The Bible says wisdom is the principal things in all that getting. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Let me get back to my note this morning. Praise God.
It's all right.
I'm going to go through effect of fasting this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Fasting changes us. Do you believe that?
Amen.
It increases our spiritual capacity.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. Fasting increases our spiritual capacity. Fasting break habits and spiritual bonding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fasting quiets your heart to hear God because your body is defeated. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The book of Romans says, to be carnally minded is death, and to be spiritually minded is life and peace. To be carnally minded, flesh cannot profit you anything. To be spiritually minded is life. Life and peace. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Fasting bring godly intimacy, get you closer to God than your wife. It gets you one-on-one to God. Fasting brings intimacy. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It brings you the mind of God. You're fasting, you're just taking shower, God is coming. This book. Share you some information and you don't even think it's going to praise the name of
God.
The place of power fasting. The place of fasting. Alright, we're going to be going to the benefit of fasting this morning. Benefit of fasting. Amen.
Amen.
One of it is it brings you spiritual discipline. Fasting brings you, make you to be spiritually disciplined. It increases your spiritual capacity. Your memory is growing and, you know, mentally alert when you fast. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You have a sharp spiritual antenna. This is not Xfinity now. This is this is spiritual antenna. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Something evil is about to cross your way. God will show it to you ahead. The Holy Spirit will lead things to come ahead. The Bible says, deep connect unto the deep. When you fast, you go deep, stronger in God. The revelation will be so easy for you to access.
Yes. Yeah.
Somebody will be walking beside you. The Lord will reveal the person to you. I was in school sometime and the guy came to me and said, hey, he found a fiancé to marry. I said, okay. I said, who is the person? No, she now introduced her to me. And I saw this lady, the head was like upside down. Like, I want to tell this man. Holy Spirit told me, don't tell him because he's not going to hear. And I said, yeah, I just went in, I prayed. Yeah, because he's not going to listen. You know what I'm saying? The Bible says there is a thing that cement rights to a man.
Come on.
The head is full of destruction. You can derive some deep things in the place of fasting.
Hallelujah.
The place of fasting is the place of power.
Yes.
It's a place of God's intimacy.
Yes.
It's a place you can relate with God. You can pour your heart to God and God will chastise you. Lord will spank you in the place of fasting and you get corrected.
Come on. Yes.
Not when you finish like McDonald's and the dog cheese. Put everything together, then you start thinking normally, and then you know, then your way will seem right. Praise the name of the Lord. Everybody say fasting. Hallelujah. Let's move forward. One of the benefits of fasting is when you fast, you hunger for God's word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then it will return you to good health. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody say, get in shape.
Get in shape. Come on.
You will lose some weight. Some excess weight. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Also, fasting saves you money. Hallelujah. Everybody says it's good to fast. It saves you money. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Fasting purifies our body.
Come on.
It gives us a spiritual freedom. It gives us a spiritual freedom. You will be free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You will be free today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Fasting make your life shine.
Hallelujah.
Try it.
Alright.
You will shine.
Amen.
I say you will shine.
Amen.
It gives you intimate with God. You want to be where God is and fast. I mean, genuine fasting. Not the fasting that you, in the breakfast, you start thinking of, this is what I'm going to eat in the dinner. And you're not focused on that kind of fasting. I'm saying fasting. Yeah, you can fast anything. You can fast. I believe you can fast anything. That's what Brother Abola said. I pray one of these days God will help him to come and share more of that.
Amen.
I know you can fast. Deny yourself. From even watching TV, you can fast with it.
Yes, sir. Yes,
I just, you know, that was the day you said it and I started thinking of it. Yeah, it's the same. You can even, after discipline of yourself, put a knife on your throat. At times when you're fasting, and you know, this fasting time, it's now this time my boss, the only boss I have in my job, came and said, let's go for lunch. And if you are fasting, you don't have to tell people you are fasting.
Come on.
Because there's no reward in it. You hear what I'm saying? That's what the scripture says. I forgot the scripture. I think it's in the book of Isaiah.
Yeah.
You can look that up. Let's look that up. It's an assignment to us. Let's look it up.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. So my boss will be like, 2 o'clock, you're going. He's been saying this. I will just like, 2 o'clock, so I have my own schedule. So from 10 to 3, I will be away from the office. So I just design myself and I'm on the feet. So when 3, I don't want to, but he has a way of like, all of us, we're going to go out together, and at least for the first time. So it is well. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is faithful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Fasting increases your retention capacity. It makes you to retain information. You will remember it's a lot of things. You get what I'm saying? Your brain will work aright. Your part of your body will function aright. Because there's no doubt jokes. There's no, you know, you have disciplined yourself, you know. You are not having schedule to go to Dano and stop by at the King of QFC. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will help us in Jesus.
Amen.
I have two guidelines for fasting before we move forward this morning. Two guidelines for fasting. Commit yourself to God. That's the number one guideline to fasting. Commit yourself to God. And the number two guideline I have for fasting is to tell you to drink a lot of water. Everybody say water.
Water.
Drink a lot of water. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. I got carried away like about a week ago and I've not been taking a lot of water. Something just happened. I can't hold it again. I have to go to medical. Praise the name of the Lord. I got to the medical room and I prescribed some medication. I said, okay, I took the medication, I took it home. And at that time, I think it was on Friday, I had a meeting. After being in the meeting for 8 hours, I cannot leave that meeting for anything. And I was not feeling too good. I just told them, I'm going to medical. And I have to go to medical again. From medical, they just transferred me home. And I was praying, and the Holy Spirit told me, drink water. So that is why I have this guideline.
Come on now.
Drink water.
Good word. Amen.
Drink water.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, drink water.
Drink water.
Drink water. Drink a lot of water. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
And shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's go to prayer structure. Amen.
Amen.
Prayer structure. Let's open our Bible to the book of Luke, chapter 11, verse 1 to 4. I need help for someone to help me out. The book of Luke, chapter 11, verse 1 to 4. Somebody to help me, please. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, sir.
That as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray. As John also taught his disciples, and he said unto them, when ye pray, say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven, so in earth. Give us day by day our daily bread.
Hallelujah. Praise Him.
And forgive us our sins. For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us.
Thank you.
And lead us not into temptation.
Hallelujah. Praise Him. Thank you, sir. And it came to pass that as He was praying in a certain place, when He ceased, one of the disciples came to say to Him, Lord, teach us how to pray. Teach us how to pray. As John also taught his disciple, and he said unto them, where ye pray, say, Our Father, we art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. So when you start to pray, hallow the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When you start to pray in your fasting, start by giving thanks for all He has done. Start by hallowing Him. Hallow be Your name. Hallow Him. Everybody say prayer structure.
Prayer structure.
There is a pattern to things. There is a way to things. God has instructions. Hallow his name. The Bible says, enter into his gate by one access with thanksgiving and to his court with prayer. Enter. So enter the door with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Everybody say hallow.
Hallow.
Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Amen.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Not do this for me, do that for me. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Everybody say, thy will.
Thy will.
Thy will be done on heart as it is in heaven. Praise the name of the Lord. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our sin. For as we forgive everyone that is indebted to us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everybody say forgive.
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 Forgiveness is a very strong thing that we cannot do without. And this has kept us behind. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me get back to my note a little bit. So, prayer is the most important kingdom activity on earth that we have to partake in it. The most important kingdom activities on earth, it is prayer. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. My time is fast spent. I thought we're going to close early today. I thought we're just going to. But glory be to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell anybody there is a price to pay.
There is a price to pay.
There is a price to pay. Hallelujah. God is faithful. Let's worship God. Let's worship God. Let's bless his name this morning. Let's give him praise. Let's appreciate him. Let's just worship him. Just speak in tongues. Let's glorify God. Listen, go ahead and pray the Holy Ghost. Pray the Holy Ghost. Pray the Holy Ghost. Pray the Holy Ghost. Rege shakata la ruba ba ba ba. Rege shakara ruba ba 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 ba. Rebo sokoto ruba raga shende gele ruba ba ba raga shekele ruba ba 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 ba. Rum ruba ba ba raga shakara ruba ba 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 raga shekele ruba. Raga shakara ruba ba 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 ba. Only forgiver and qualified for forgiveness. Let's speak unto the Lord. Lord, help me. Help me, Lord. Help me to forgive. To set myself in high place. Help me to see. To forgive in the name of Jesus. Raga shakara ba 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 ba. As you pray, go ahead and let go everyone that you have you thought you cannot let go. Go ahead and speak of the Lord's mind. Go ahead and let it go. Lord, help me to forgive. Help me to forgive. Help me to forgive. That is the only one thing that can hinder your progress. That is the only one thing that can hinder your prayer. Somebody has stepped on your feet. Let the person go now. Go ahead and pray. Pray, pray in the Holy Ghost. Lord, give me the grace to forgive. Give me the grace to forgive. Reba shakata rabra baba raga shekere bruba baba bariga. Rege shekere bruba baba 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 baba. Rege shekere bo. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
If you don't forgive, will you put yourself into the hand of eternity torment? Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, forgiveness. I step on toes a lot, but you know I don't even know where to start. Thank God for my wife. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. At times I forget to even apologize, but before you offend me, I forgive you. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for where I have learned it.
Amen.
As I even forget to even say sorry. So, I'm supposed to lead prayers and then probably I think I stepped up. It's a sin. See, the only thing I do is that God forgive me.
Amen.
When God forgive me, and if you still keep it, it's, you know, because it's that thing, you know, if he's not taking you, you're like, what is this man doing? But,
thank you, Jesus.
Tell your neighbor, little things that matters.
Little things that matters.
Forgive. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's rest on you this morning. Let's worship. Rest your feet. Worship Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Tell him to help you to be the dweller on this world today. Lord, help me. Help me to forgive. Help me, oh God, to wait upon you. Help me to wait upon you, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. Grant me the grace to fast and pray according to your mandate. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says men ought to pray and not to faint. If you are fainting, if you are not praying, you are shocking. You are not breathing. If you are not breathing, you are shocking. The place of prayer is a place of breathing. As a Christian, the Bible says, men ought to pray and not to faint. Where I speak unto the Lord, where I ask for the grace of God this morning, that God has for the grace to pray, the grace to pray and not to faint, the grace to be a prayer warrior and not to be faint, the grace to be to pray and to fast. God grant unto me this day.
Amen.
Thank you, mighty God. Blessed be your name, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That song says, my life is no man.
Yes.
Let's do that song. Let's do that song. Let's ask for his help as we do that song. Let's ask for God's help this morning. Lord, I ask for your help this morning. Help me hold on in my prayer life. Let's sing that song better. Let's sing it out.
Let's sing that song.
Bible says,
my
power is equal zero. You are healed. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, mighty God. We give you glory. We give you praise.
praise. We appreciate your name, Lord Jesus. Come on, let's sing his praise. 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 One day in this morning, we glorify this morning. We're going to sing his praise. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Let's give a big hands up to the Lord. Hallelujah. It's well worth it.